Deadly brawl in Midtown Sacramento leaves police searching for suspects.
This was hand-to-hand combat. They beat this kid to a pulp.
It happened early this morning, shortly before 1 a.m. at 18th and P Streets. Witnesses say it was so brutal that anyone who have tried to have stopped it would have gotten hurt too. The 19's Claire Dwan filed the story just before she went to Stockton.
And it was just a horrific, savage beating. And there was nothing you could do. You couldn't intervene. You couldn't intercede because you would become a victim.
This neighbor did not want to show his face on camera, afraid of the three guys whom police say got in a fight with a man in his 20s. The witness says he was walking by as it went down.
I heard some guy yelling at some other guy saying, "Don't you ever such and such." And then I just heard crack, 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 just one after another, rapid succession, like gunfire almost. But it was definitely the sound of bone against bone.
The victim, who's in his 20s, died at the hospital from those injuries. Police say no weapons were involved, but they still don't know what started the fight. They're now looking at surveillance video from the area.
We're trying to figure out exactly who's who in videos, where things might have happened, if it happened earlier in the night.
Nearby residents say they're used to rowdy bar crowds, but news of this deadly brawl is sobering.
It was crazy because, I mean, not just that someone died like out here, but the way that happened is really insane.
I'm not too nervous about my safety, but it definitely sticks in the back of my head now as something to look out for.
Now witnesses and neighbors hope police can track down the suspects.
They were not going to stop. This man was not going to get up and walk away, and they were going to make sure of it.
In downtown Sacramento, Claire Dwan, KCRA 319.
Right now, detectives will only say that they're looking for three male suspects. No specifics on the description are just as of yet. They're also hoping that anyone with information will come forward and contact the police.